Teens often think they're invincible, that nothing bad can or will happen to them, especially when it comes to driving. According to SaveMoLives.org, only 67% of Missouri teens wear their seatbelt, and Chad Burton wasn't one of them on December 29th, 1992.
You definitely don't want your parents changing your diaper and your stuff like that when you're 17, 18. They shouldn't have to help give you a bath and stuff.
It was just 4 days after Christmas 20 years ago. Chad Burton was driving on Rock Quarry Road in Columbia a little after midnight.
I was in a coma for 5.5 weeks, 39 days.
The injury report says the 17-year-old high school sophomore wrestler fell asleep while driving and hit another driver who had been drinking. Burton wasn't wearing a seatbelt.
I lost a lot of my memory. Physically, I lost one side of my body. I can't move the left side of my body, so I do everything with one hand.
It wasn't just Burton who was affected by the crash. His parents also were hit hard.
They had to sell their house that we owned in order to move to Columbia. We had to move to Columbia into a trailer so I could just be closer to the hospital at the time.
He went to physical therapy several times a week and returned to Rockbridge High School. He was relentless in his effort. Eventually, he graduated and later passed a special test for a driver's license. He's taken his struggles and turned them into teaching lessons as a Voice for Injury Prevention speaker for Think First Missouri. He shows them how he can tie his shoes with just one hand and how he can type with just 5 fingers. It's all while he tells the students about the dangers on the roads.
The single most important thing, I think, is to make it a life commitment to wear your seatbelt every time you get in your car.
He says as drivers, we take our fate into our own hands every time we get behind the wheel.
Worry about your own body, because if you don't worry about your safety, who's going to? It's not going to be the guy coming at you that's drinking and driving or texting and driving or talking on his phone and driving. You've got to put those things down.
I asked Burton if he could go back in time, would he change what happened? After some thought, he said he would have worn a seatbelt that night, but at the same time, he says he wouldn't want to give up the experiences he's had as a result, the incredible people he's met along the way, or the countless teen lives he's impacted through Think First Missouri. Megan Lane, KRCG 13 News.